Hello and welcome to another Java and Android Studio tutorial. My name is Cal and in this tutorial we're going to be looking at radio groups and radio buttons. We're just going to implement a fairly basic radio group with four different radio buttons, each being a different genre of music, and we're just going to take the value of the radio button that's selected and put it into a text view. So pretty basic. Also in this video, we're gonna do a whole bunch of customization and make the radio group look and feel the way that we want. So we're gonna dabble into some styles as well as changing the colors and the whole look and feel of just your standard radio group and make it look and feel the way that we like. I've just chosen these colors and the borders and all that sort of thing, but it's really just an example of how you can customize the radio group to look and feel exactly how you want. You don't just have to stick with the generic Android implementation. So yeah, with all that said, there is a link in the description to the source code and let's get started. Creating a new Android Studio project, empty activity, giving it a name of custom radio group tutorial. Java is our programming language. The first thing we're gonna do is head into our main XML and just make the text a little bigger and the color black, and then remove that top constraint and give it a little bit of margin to the top, 10 dp. Giving our text view an ID, so just calling it text view. Below our text view, we're gonna create a radio group. I'm just gonna give it a width of 250 dp and a height of wrap content. And then I'm gonna copy down the to the left of and to the right of parent constraint, as well giving our radio group top to bottom of our text view, as well just giving our radio group margin top 10 dp. And then inside our radio group, I'm gonna create a radio button. For this example, we're gonna use music genres, so I'm just giving the first one an ID. And then I'm gonna create a new resource file. I'm gonna call it styles.xml. And then I'm gonna right click on our styles.xml and say split vertically, just so we can have that on the screen at the same time as our main activity. So inside our styles.xml, I'm gonna define a new style. I'm gonna call it radio button style. This style we're going to apply to all of our radio buttons, and it's just going to store all of the common attributes. So we're going to start with width. Each radio button is going to have the same width, so it's just easier to put it in here, and that way if you need to change it in the future, it's all in one place. You don't have to go through and change each value individually. And then inside our radio button, I'm going to call our style. So I'm just going to say style is equal to style and radio button style. And then I'm just going to give our radio button a little bit of text so that we can see what's going on. I'm going to give our styles text color to be black, as well as a text size to be 30 SP. Next, we're gonna remove the default radio button. The Android button is null. You can see it removed the little button there. We're gonna give our style the gravity of center, as well as an on click, and I'm just gonna call it radio tap. And then just to create that method, I'm just gonna head into our radio button and create that radio tapped method, and then just remove it again. This seems like the easiest way to do it. And then I'm just gonna copy down that radio button three more times and change the text and the IDs. In this radio group example, we're gonna have a radio button for metal music, a radio button for classical music, and a radio button for pop music, as well as a radio button for jazz music. And while we're changing text values, we could probably change our hello world to something a bit more informative. So I'm just gonna say favorite genre. Next, I'm just going to extract each of those strings to a string resource, create some background styles for our radio group, a new drawable resource file. I'm going to call this radio group background, and then right click on our drawable folder once more and calling this one radio on, and then third time as well, calling this one radio off. And then we're going to click on our radio group background and just change it to shape. And then our shape is going to be a rectangle. Then we're going to add in a solid color, and I'm going to create a new color for this. I'm going to call it light gray, and it is going to be E6, 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 giving our solid that color of light gray. Our stroke is going to have a width of 2 dp as well as a color of black, and the corners we're going to give it a radius of 5 dp. To make things nice and easy, we're just going to copy what we've done here and put it into our radio on.xml, except we're going to change the color to be white, and we're going to do the same thing, so paste that again into radio off, and we're actually going to get rid of everything except for the shape. Nice. So heading back into our main XML, we're just going to call Android background and give our background of our radio group background. And then from each of our radio buttons, we're going to give it a background of drawable radio off, except for one, we're going to give it radio on. And looking at our design view on the right there, we can see that our custom radio group layout is all looking good. Nice. So next we can start on our Java class. I'm just going to create a text view, naming it text view. Next, we're going to declare four radio buttons, classical, pop, and jazz. Next, we're going to declare a simple method called initWidgets, and we're just going to find each of our widgets, so our text view and our radio buttons. We're going to find each of them by the appropriate ID. So I'm just calling text view and finding the view by text view, and then metal and metal, and so on and so forth. Cool. And then right down the bottom, I'm going to create another method. I'm going to call this update radio group, and it's going to take a radio button. I'm going to call this selected. And then we're just going to say metal.setBackground to contextCompat.getDrawable. And then I'm going to give it the application context as well as our ID of our radio off. And then I'm going to copy and paste that down for all four of our radio buttons. So we're just going to set the to look off for every single one of our radio buttons. And then below this, we're going to say selected background and set it to on. So turn all four of our radio buttons off and then turn the one that was selected, turn it back on to look selected. String selected string is equal to get string, find our favorite genre, a new line, as well as selected.getText. Set our text view to our selected string. And in our onCreate, I'm just going to call this update radio group method and pass it in metal, but you can choose any of the radio buttons you like. In our radio tapped, I'm just going to say int selected ID is equal to view.getID. If selected ID is equal to r.id.metal, as in this method is being called from our metal radio button, we're going to update our radio group and passing it in our radio button, which is metal. And then we're going to copy and paste that down and just say else if and give it classical and pass our update radio group with classical. We're going to do the exact same thing, but for pop and jazz. If we build and run this now, you should be able to see that we've got a pretty sweet looking custom radio group. I'm just going to center that text alignment. But yeah, there you have it. That was a custom radio group tutorial in Android Studio using Java. And I'll catch you guys in the next tutorial.